Hey folks, we're here today with Kim Dye, and she's the Lady Tiger basketball coach at Fayetteville High School. And as everybody knows, basketball's just around the corner getting ready to kick off. Appreciate you sitting down with us, coach.
Thank
Talk
you,
a few
Mr.
minutes
Paul.
About your Lady Tigers. This is your third year as head coach of
Lady
Tiger basketball?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now, you've got a change in your assistants this year. Who's going to be your assistant coach?
Coach Alvin Palmer is going to be helping me this year. He's really, really excited about it, and the girls are looking forward to it, so it'll be a different a change. You know, we'll have a man voice now instead of three women. So it's going to be a positive change, I think, for all of us, so we're looking forward to it.
Okay. Now, he's got some background as a basketball coach. People just kind of program to think of him as a football guy, but he's actually got a lot of time on the court coaching basketball.
I think he's got about 33 years worth of experience coaching basketball. So
it's not his first rodeo?
Not his first rodeo.
Okay. Now, you guys are a member of District 9A. Cascade was there last year, but they're not there this year. You've still got Fayetteville, Huntland, Moore County, Community, Middle Tennessee Christian, Forest, and Eagleville.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You got a feeling of who may be some of the stronger forces in the district? I know Moore County lost the Raby girl and some key players. Of course, they constantly kind of reload over there.
They do. I think Middle Tennessee Christian is probably going to be the team to beat this year for the top spot running. With the loss of Cascade, I mean, Cascade dominated last year with Moore County. Moore County's in a building year. Eagleville and Forest are about our age, so we're all kind of the same stage right there. Community's always usually pretty good. They have a lot of experience, some good athletes too over there. So, I mean, it's kind of a toss-up, but I think Middle Tennessee Christian would be the stronger team this year.
Okay. Now, your ladies are going to be running on a shiny new refinished gym floor here.
They are. It looks good.
On Tiger Hill. So that was a project they did over the summer, I think.
Yes, sir.
Getting everything refinished.
Yes, sir.
No, it's an unusual floor. Kind of give you an idea of my age. I came here in 1968 when they built this thing, and it was called a floating floor. There was actually a rubber pad that kind of cushions it just a little bit, but it's amazing the shape and condition that this thing's maintained in. So I know y'all will be excited about that. You want to go through your roster?
I can.
We'll see who you got playing. Let me know a little bit about them, who's coming back. And I think you've even got a couple of new girls this
year. I'll start with my senior. She's a lone senior, Lexi Horton. I expect lots of good things out of her this year. She's had an awesome preseason, an awesome summer. She hasn't hardly missed a day of conditioning, and she's really stepping up into a leader role. She's a good kid. Anything you ask her to do, she's going to try her best to do it. So,
what kind of work do you all do in the off season where you're really? I mean, I know there's certain limitations by TSSAA regulations, but what kind of off season type conditioning program do you all do
this year? Obviously, you want to try to, you know, get in the weight room and run, but this year we've concentrated more on running versus anything. With seven kids, you've got to be in shape. Otherwise, you're going to break down physically, you're going to break down mentally, et cetera. So we've been on the track, we've been in the gym, we've been doing fun runs, sprints, long distance. I mean, you name it, that's what we've been doing. And then basketball-wise, all they've really had to do is hit a certain amount of three-pointers on their own time. So I've had a lot of kids come up here on the weekend and get some shots up, and then after school and during basketball they get some shots in. So
okay, we'll go ahead.
Okay, moving on down, I have two juniors coming back this year. Tamia Baker, she's going to be a three-point threat. Hopefully she's getting more consistent with her shot, so hopefully she can, you know, knock down some threes for us. Threes, you don't realize how quickly you can be ahead or be behind if you're hitting or missing.
Sure.
So hopefully she'll step up in that role for us pretty good. And then Jasmine Parks. Jasmine Parks, she's an undersized post player. I would probably say that I'm taller than she is. But she works hard and she's extremely strong and knows how to use her body pretty well. Okay. So she's played against some, you know, the Raby kid from Moore County. So, I mean, she's gotten experience by just watching and learning other good players in our district. So hopefully she's going to have a good year. My sophomores, Kiri Brown. Kiri is like a gnat. Everywhere you go, she's going to be there and she's going to be matching you step for step. She's probably our best defender on ball. She's extremely quick. Her eighth grade year was her first year to ever play basketball. Okay. So in 2 years, she's improved a lot.
She had some injury problems last year, didn't she?
She did, and missed probably a lot of the second part of the season.
Yeah.
So
she back healthy,
she's
in good shape?
Everybody's good. Everybody's good.
Wonderful.
My other sophomore is Treva Thompson. She's my point guard. She's all out 100%, sometimes to the point where I have to tell her to slow down. Okay. She's a hard-nosed kid. She works hard. I expect big things from her. She was all district last year as a freshman, so hopefully she can put up good numbers this year as well. And then I have two newcomers, Mackenzie Moorhead and Sarah Lawson. These two kids are probably my hardest working kids in the sense of I don't have to stay on them all the time. They're gonna get after it. Okay. And not have to be pushed. They're loyal kids, and what I mean by that is they're gonna spend the next 4 years really getting after it in basketball, you know, trying to do what's best for the team, what's best for them individually.
Now, did they come through the middle school program?
They
here?
Did. They played for us last year.
They went. Your middle school program went pretty deep last year.
Mm-hmm. We finished fourth,
I think, postseason
in the little state tournament. So, okay. We're looking forward to it.
Okay. What kind of ball do you? I mean, I know depth is an issue. It's got to even be affecting you at practice. You know, having enough kids to work and work on, you know, full court press and things like that. But what are you still going to go ahead and try to run with these teams? You're going to slow it down, play more of a half court game?
It's just going to depend. I think that's what I was telling the girls, you know, day in, day out, like the teams that we play is going to be something different every night. For our kids, obviously, like you said, you only have seven, so you have to be smart in what you're wanting to do, what you need to do. But also, we can't just sit back and let teams kind of do what they want to do, you know.
Sure.
So it's almost a game that we have to play every night in the sense of, you know, what should we do tonight strategically that can help us win the basketball game. Practice wise, we try our best to bring in some old college friends of mine or just people that I know grew up playing basketball. Right. Against. They try to come in and help us scrimmage. Obviously, it's different when you go 5-on-0 versus 5-on-5.
Sure.
So we're hoping to set up a scrimmage with Cascade next week, possibly. Chad and I are really good friends. He helped coach me in high school.
Okay.
So, you know, another good team that they can go against, and it'd
right.
be more a constructive scrimmage versus roll the ball out and go play.
Right.
So.
Right. Okay. Now, your season kicks off November the 12th, you're right. Mm-hmm. It's at Cornersville, and it's the Hall of Champions. Is that what it's called? Is it like a tournament?
It's like a Hall of Fame game. It's just kind of
– okay.
That's how it's labeled. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then November 14th, you're on the road at Richland. Then you've got your first home game of the season against Cullioca.
Yes, sir.
On November the 18th.
Yes, sir.
Now, I know there's a little variance in your start times, but most of the girls' games get done away at 6 o'clock.
Yes, sir.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, appreciate you folks. Come out and support these Lady Tigers. They're building a program here in a real tough little district, District 9A, and we wish you luck, Coach.
Thank you, Mr. Pearl. I appreciate it.
Hey, folks, we're here today with Coach Chris Murdoch. He's the head basketball coach at Federal High School. Appreciate you talking with us a few minutes, Coach, about your Tigers. This is your third year as a varsity program here at Federal. But now you were the junior high coach here prior to it becoming a high school program. Is that right?
That's right. 2 years.
2 years. So this is your fifth
school.
Year.
This is my fifth year.
Working in the system. Well, that's good. That's good. Mm-hmm. Now, who's your assistant going to be this year?
This year it's going to be Frank Stevens,
okay.
Who is our vice principal as well, athletic director, and he's comes from a long line of history of basketball. He's coached in the Huntsville area, the Madison County area, his whole life, and thought it'd be best to bring him on and bring his knowledge of the game with him.
Okay. Well, that's good. That's good. It'd be a good helping hand for you, I'm sure. Last year's team, for second year playing in it, what was your record? You had really a considerable, a successful season last year.
Yeah, we finished 14-11.
Okay. How were you in the district standings?
Well, the district, we finished third.
Okay.
In the district standings going into the tournament, which top four teams got to host opening round district game.
Right.
And unfortunately, we lost that game by 6. So we were done, but I think it just made us better for this year.
Good learning experience for the young players.
And made them hungry and know what they have to do to take that next step in their season.
Compete at that level. Now, this will be the first year you've had any senior ball players on your team. Is that right?
That's right. We have two this year.
Okay.
I believe Aaron Parks and Darren Patterson are our two seniors this year.
So you've got really a slew of young guys that are still coming up and developing their skills that'll be with you for a while.
Right. Yeah, we have, I think it's 5 juniors, and we have 1 sophomore, and then bringing in 4 freshmen. So that's our future coming up.
All right. Who do you, knowing the teams the way you know in your district, who do you kind of foresee as being one of the stronger teams or the powerhouse in District 9A?
Well, I hope it this year has turned into our year.
Absolutely.
But there's two more teams that are right there, at the same boat, having a lot of people back, would be Middle Tennessee Christian, and they're bringing back a former Mr. Basketball, single A. He's a senior this year. And then also Community High School, who went to the sub-state game. They were 1 game away last year from the state tournament. They bringing back majority of their whole team. So I feel like those three, with us included, will fight for that top spot this year in the district standings.
Okay. Well, you want to go through your roster and give us an idea of who you got and what roles they'll play?
Yeah, sure. We'll just go numerical order, and we start off with number 5. That's Michael Parks. Michael is a junior this year, and he's been a 3-year starter. He's developed into a leadership role. He's really come a long ways. He's known for his defense and his offense. I mean, he's really taken that next step in his offensive game. He's able to knock down the shot, create for himself. He's kind of like a second point guard on the court for us. Then we'll move on. Number 10 is brother Aaron Parks. He's a senior this year. Again, he comes in 3 years starting. And his role on the team, he's a great shooter. He might be one of the best shooters we have. He's a quick guard. He can make people miss. He's good on defense. He just brings that third year of experience with him as a senior. Number 12 is Darion King. Darion has really developed his game, and I think he's ready to take it to the next level. He's been coming off the bench, and he plays his role very well for us. Developed into a good shooter, like I said. The next one, number 14, Nicholas Hopkins. He's our only sophomore on the team, and he'll also, 3-year starter coming in. He started as an 8th grader.
Right.
His game, he's the floor general out there. He's the point guard. He makes the calls. He relays the calls. Great kid, does everything out there. He's really developed his body in the sense of his physicalness, putting on weight, putting on muscle, and he's going to be able to get in that lane. He's going to be able to push people around now this year.
I've noticed he's grown up a little bit.
Yeah. I mean, people saw him as an 8th grader. Now he's a sophomore. The body's developing. The muscles are developing.
Yeah. I believe he'll end up being a little bigger kid than his brother Fitz.
Well, he's got a good role model to follow in Fitz. So.
That's a fact. Good work ethic.
Mm-hmm. Next person we bring in, number 20, Isaiah Marsh. He's a freshman this year. He's new to the program. So we're interested to see, how he develops in practice. And, this is different for us because we actually have veterans who can help develop freshmen. We've never had that before. This is our first year for that. And to see him, we'll see Isaiah rise through the ranks and develop as a player. And this year is kind of like a learning year for him. He's a sponge. He's going to soak it all in.
Okay.
We bring next is number 21, Kendrell Hall. Kendrell's a football player who will join us after the football season's over. Again, he's been with the team since seventh grade. He's a great kid, great defender, on-ball defender. He's got quick feet and he's got quick hands. He runs the guard position out there on offense. And like I said, he'll be in with us after football season's over. Number 23 next, Darren Patterson, also a football player. He's the other senior. Darren, he came to us as a sophomore, and he's been with us for, going into his third year. Darren is a great shooter, great kid. I look for him to play a big role this year in the season and, helping us win games.
Okay.
Next, we bring in 30, James Keith. James is a junior. James is kind of that 1-5 player almost. He's almost the tallest player on our team at 6'1", which isn't very tall, but he can play that every position, the guard, 1-5. James is a great kid, great work ethic. And again, he's really developed his body from a skinny, slender kid to putting on some muscle and some weight this year. And he's worked on his jump shot a lot, and it's really progressed from his freshman year. 32, Osborne Cow. He's a transfer student. He was with us in middle school, left his freshman year and sophomore year, went to school down in Huntsville, came back with us this year. He brings that physicalness that we need. He's thick, he's strong. He's about 6'2 to 6'3. He'll be able to join us at the end of the year for eligibility since he transferred, but he's going to be able to bring that inside presence that we need.
Okay.
Next is number 33, Brandon Folston. Brandon's a freshman as well. He's new to the team, new to the program, just looking to see him, develop and grow for years to come. And 34 is the next. It's Michael Buchanan. Michael's a football player. He'll be joining us when they get out of football. He's a freshman. He came in through the middle school team, and now he's going to be with us. He got to go to camp with us this summer. He got to learn a lot, watch, and play in those JV games and some in the varsity, and I feel like he'll be able to develop his game as a basketball player.
Okay.
And the last player is number 42, Kane McWilliams. Again, another football player that will join us afterwards when they're done. And, Kane comes in. He's very developed as a freshman body-wise. He's about 6'1", I would say almost 200 pounds near. Mm-hmm. Like I said, he's very developed, so he'll be able to help us with the inside presence. Once he learns the plays, once he learns the system, I really think he'll have a grasp on things and be able to come in and help us win some ball games this year.
Okay. One thing you're definitely to your advantage, the guys you've had for a while, they've been to develop their skills. And like you say, it's always good, too, to have them working with these young guys that are coming up. Now, of course, we want Coach P to keep winning football games as long as he possibly can, but you're going to be four guys light.
Yeah, four guys light. We'll go
until football's wrapped up.
Until football's over. We'll go in with, I believe it's seven guys, our first game. And then we'll see how far football progresses in their season, and we'll play with who we have, and, I'll make changes accordingly. And like I said, some of those two new freshmen they're going to have to play.
Right.
Just get in there, get some minutes, do positive things, and help out for these guys, give them some winded breaks, because playing with seven the way we like to play, you're going to get tired. So.
Yeah. In the past, when I've watched your teams play, you guys are much more successful in a running type situation. That seems to be
right.
the type ball you've got versus setting up and running a half-court offense and that type thing. And, I'd say one of the better ways to defend against you guys is to slow the ball down a little bit and have them run a half-court game. But that seems like the success that you've had has been doing that. And believe me, folks, it makes for exciting basketball. Between you got some good three-point shooters, you got some people that can smoke it up and down this basketball court.
Yeah.
So it's real exciting basketball. It truly is. Now, your first game is November the 12th. You're on the road in Cornersville. Then the 14th, you go to Richland. Then on the 18th, you've got your first game at home against Cullioca. And I've noticed one game too you've got on here, and it's definitely playing up. Is you got a game with Coffee County?
Yeah, I scheduled a.
There's a 6A school in football, so but they're definitely a 3A program in basketball.
Right. This season, going into it, when I made out the schedule, I said, you know, I want these kids to be challenged with their non-district games. Like you said, we have Coffee County. We added Giles County for a home and home. The tournaments we go to, we're playing some well-rounded teams. Watertown, a state tournament team. Playing Richland again, a state tournament team. Summertown's always good. Playing them, so I put the schedule together to challenge us, mm-hmm. you know, to get us ready for that district tournament to play some tough teams. So we'll know what to do in a hostile environment or a road situation, things like that.
Right, right. Well, it's, you know, it's the old adage goes, your competition is what makes you better.
Yeah, yeah. So you always want to play up.
You always want to play up. Well, folks, if you want to see some exciting basketball, come out and watch these Tigers. They know how to handle the ball on the court. And appreciate you watching, and we'll see you next time.